After Kerwin Espinosa's explosive revelation Thursday that he was coerced into implicating Senator Leila de Lima in the alleged illegal drug trade, the Justice Department will now look into filing perjury charges against the self-confessed drug lord. Justice Secretary Minado Guevara says he will discuss this with a panel of prosecutors, noting that making false statements under oath is a criminal offense. But what about the allegations of coercion? Guevara says that will be determined when Espinosa faces perjury charges, adding Espinosa will have to prove his claims. In his counter-affidavit submitted to the DOJ Thursday, Espinosa said the statements he made about De Lima were false as he was pressured, coerced, intimidated, and threatened by the police to implicate De Lima in the illegal drug trade. The Justice Department reiterated Friday the retraction will have no effect on De Lima's two pending drug cases because Espinosa was never used and will not be used by the prosecution as their witness. The DOJ also questioned the truthfulness and motive of the retraction, given that it came more than 5 years after his Senate testimony in 2016. Prosecutor General Benedicto Malcontento, for his part, pushes back against Espinosa's allegations that authorities pressured him to testify against De Lima.
Ang pagtistiko ni Kerwin Espinosa nasa Senado, wala sa Huskado, wala sa Department of Justice. So wala kaming kinalaman dyan, wala kaming control dyan. Dapat ang tumingin dyan yung Senado. Ano ang gagawin ng Senado sa mga testigo na nagpipresyum tayo na posibleng nagsisinungaling? Ang na-disrespect dito ay ang Senado, hindi kami. Kasi to begin with, hindi namin testigo si Kerwin Espinosa.
But it was former Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre who reportedly talked to inmates to testify against De Lima and who announced that Espinosa will most likely drag De Lima into the illegal drug trade, even before Espinosa could testify before the Senate. Espinosa's lawyer defended his client against doubts on his motives, saying he was forced to answer the allegations in the new complaint the National Bureau of Investigation filed against him based on his Senate testimony.
The cases filed against him are based on his confession. So he would not want to be convicted on his confession, which was, according to him, he was forced to give. Imagine, his father was just killed 21 days before the Senate inquiry. He told me that there are threats, pressure from all from the police. That's why he was forced to tell these stories, even implicating Senator De Lima in the illegal drug trade.
Attorney Palat could not, however, say if Aguirre was among those who supposedly forced his client to testify.
Honestly, I have no idea. No? As I said, I was not the lawyer then of Kerwin. He told me generally it's the police who were pressuring him into telling lies and to implicate people in the illegal drug trade at the Bilibid Penitentiary. No names were given to me by Kerwin as of this time.
De Lima, who has spent the past 5 years behind bars and drug-related charges, says Espinosa's retraction only proves the lengths President Rodrigo Duterte and his minions have gone to fabricate testimony and evidence against her to fulfill Duterte's deep-seated personal vendetta. It was De Lima who led the Senate probe into Duterte's drug war. She previously investigated the Davao Death Squad. De Lima claims the Department of Justice used Espinosa and other convicts to create lies about her and about crimes that she did not commit. She hopes that more convict witnesses will confess and reveal the names of those behind her frame-up so she can bring them to account. De Lima, who is running an uphill campaign to be re-elected, is optimistic that as the Duterte administration's power comes to an end, so will the lies, and the truth shall finally set her free. Mike Navallo, ABS-CBN News.